back to the LHS Marching Band podcast. I'm your host today.
And I'm your host, Lauren.
And tonight, we have a special episode for you as we recap not only the 2022-2023 season for the band, but we also wish goodbye to the seniors as they prepare for graduation.
You say that like we aren't also seniors.
Shh, it's from the band.
To start off this episode, we're going to discuss moments where the band wasn't quite show ready. A production takes trial and error, and sometimes those errors are a lot funnier than others. So let's rank them.
Starting at number 10, we have Maddox constantly losing his shoes on the field. Please, we're begging you, enough with the Crocs, and get some good ankles.
And at number 9, we have the band room. Hey, why is it always a mess? And why is it shaped like that?
Number 8, we have the 2022 seniors not making a senior video. Don't worry, guys. We may have taken all the commie skills, but at least you had Crazy in Love.
Number 7, we have Ryan falling while doing karaoke's at physical warm-ups. That's not what we meant by hit the ground running.
Coming in at number 6 is Andreas falling.
How funny that he fell!
Coming in at number 6 is Andreas falling and showing us all what we didn't need to see. Just a heads up, bud, there is a sewing kit in the band room.
Leading the way in the top 5 is Brian falling on his amp. He will tell you it was only once, but we have sources that say otherwise.
At number 4 are the various disasters that have struck our dearly beloved marimba, Rico Suave. This includes every time the cord has snapped right before a performance and the breaking of our dearly loved E key.
In 3rd place are the tragic inverted cymbals a la Evan Zumwalt. While I'm not sure if they're made of bronze, they have certainly won it for this performance.
Number 2 spot brings us to Mr. Bergeron's inability to spell on band app. Not even Grammarly could help this man announce rehearsals cancellation.
Last but not least, taking the cake in 1st place is the Micah Finals hi-hat tragedy of 2022. Always in our hearts, but not anymore in our golf carts.
We now have for you a found recording for one of our many post-rehearsal rituals, where you see students suffering from a deadly Eyes with Pride syndrome, a disease found to originate from UMass Amherst.
Taste whatever disease is in here.
How are your feet?
Together.
Stomach?
In.
Chest?
Out.
Shoulders?
Back.
Elbows?
Frozen.
Chin?
Up.
Eyes?
With pride.
How are your eyes?
With pride.
And who's got the best band around?
Well, that was riveting. Next, we have an amazing performance by our incredible drum 9, the best section. They will be performing When I Met You, Well, that was riveting. Next, we have
We sure do.
Oh my God.
Uh-oh.
I can't. They will be performing When I Met You in the Summer, an incredible story of love and also a season.
1, 2, 3, 4.
When I Met You in the Summer.
Before we can continue this show's regularly scheduled program, we want to take a moment to recognize our sponsor.
Today's podcast is sponsored by Leonidas Maldonado's freshly fermented Arizona watermelon juice cocktail.
If you're ever in the need for a game of Russian roulette, you would like to test your luck in surviving this drink, you can find this beverage in your nearest band room locker.
Leonidas & Co. are not responsible for any adverse reactions after consuming this liquid. All licensing and trademarks are reserved to the LHS MPD 2023.
We once again like to thank Leonidas Maldonado & Co. for the wonderful sponsor of this podcast. Without them, this show wouldn't be possible.
Now it's time for our favorite segment, meme review. First up, we have this glorious meme, inspired by Mr. Bergeron's inability to have any creativity when it comes to drumline parts, especially for dance tunes. We appreciate it because it means we don't have to learn any new parts, but sometimes we don't want to play rock beat. Next, we have the percussion judge and Chris's incredible relationship.
Oh, so good. Mwah.
Enemies to lovers. Chris's progress from being a timid player to a confident player in sort of this crazy world, knocking down his hopes and dreams. You know, this percussion judge, is a true American tragedy.
Yes, yes. Truly. This is a sign of patriotism in this meme.
Next, we have a clearly entirely homemade meme featuring yours truly.
This is some true creativity.
Right. It's a bit concert band centered, but I think you get the point. Gil is obnoxious. We love you, Gil. We really do. We love you very much. Please, I swear to God, if I ever hear that again, I will jump out of a three-story building.
It's getting old.
It's getting old. We've mentioned this earlier, the shoe debacle. We feel it's such a huge issue. We must bring to light this issue once more.
Maddox,
please.
Are they in sports mode?
Please put normal shoes on for anyone. Just do it. Not that hard. We love the Joker colors. We do.
Yes.
But you can get those colors. You can get them in sneakers. Athletic sneakers. And next we have Miles and the coins. He's constantly dropping on the floor. Oh my god, kid. What's going on here? You're like the kid from the Polar Express with the marbles.
When I think back on the Disney trip, every 2 feet, bud. They are coins. You do have pockets.
Next up is sort of another homemade where the photo itself is also from our own album.
The comedic value of this photograph alone sets it at a solid 9.8. Yes. We know you have issues carrying the berry sacks, Elias, but it is really funny.
Your pain is our humor. And of course, not only is this the best chaperone, the best mother, but also the best meme.
Miss Jen Dietz, you have progressed. Above all,
thank you for an experience that
I can't.
We will never forget. I am nearly brought to tears just thinking of it.
Not only did you hand us money every day of
literally,
Disney.
Literally every corner, at every corner, you're answering questions. You're goofing and gaffing with us. Yep.
You admit when you have no idea what's going on. We really,
humility,
really appreciate that.
The humility. We can't thank you enough. And we cannot thank all of the chaperones enough. You were all incredible people. But especially Miss Dietz.
Miss Dietz. What a woman.
What a woman.
If she ran a church, I'd be going every day.
Yes. Yep.
Okay, well that includes meme review.
And with the meme review all wrapped up, we can officially move towards the more serious part of the show. Our lovely seniors have so graciously donated their time to answer a few questions about their experiences in band. So, without further ado, enjoy our special guests.
Out of all the years you've been in band, what's been your favorite memory?
My favorite memory was probably the first year when I joined band. We got to play a really nice show of Queen.
My favorite memories are probably the ones at football games, specifically halftime performances. It's something about the energy that everyone brings and the humor that's in it, but also the ability to take it seriously and put our best foot forward is just some of the best energy, and I don't think anything will ever be as incredible as that. Like, I'll never experience that same feeling again.
Definitely the icicle ball. I feel like that was a great way to end that year, especially because COVID happened like right afterwards, and so we ended on a really high note, and I got to have a lot of fun with my friends, and I feel like that was just a real embodiment of how fun band can be. And I think the football games were also my favorite, because there's nothing like being in the stands and playing with your friends and having no idea what's going on, but pretending like you do, and then someone with a microphone is yelling at you to play a song, and you're just like, okay, I will.
My favorite memory from band is honestly just getting to know people. There's a lot of really cool people I've gotten to know and grown really close to because of band, and I've had a lot of amazing opportunities because of band, and it absolutely paid off. I'm very glad that I did it.
Like there's a lot of different like ones, just the kids, but like my favorite one so far is like a group was the Thanksgiving Day game. It hurt, but I actively think about it. Like, I would live it again, but I don't think I want to. But it's definitely one of the more favorite ones though, because like knowing that everybody was gonna wave at you and then going, oh.
What would you say was the hardest part of being in band?
The first week in summer, doing the band camps, those are always tough. But push through it and it gets better.
Consistency, it can be quite difficult to bring 100% every single rehearsal. I mean, there's points when you rehearse 30, 40 hours a week, and I think the hardest part is bringing as much as you can every single second.
The physical strain that it puts on you. I feel like no matter what instrument you play, you hurt when you go home, and then you sleep for a really long time, and you pretend like it didn't happen, and you have to get up the next day and do it all over again. Taking criticism is really hard as well. It can hurt to know that you're putting your best and you're still not doing quite well enough. But when you are able to overcome that, it feels really good.
The time commitment, it's a lot of time. It's like a couple hours a day, 3 days a week, a full week in August, and a lot of practice outside. Again, it is worth it.
So we're not talking physical pain that happened every time, right? Or are we talking that too? Because that would probably be it. You know, just the amount of physical takeaway that you had to put a lot of physical effort in.
What would you give as advice for a student who's just starting out in band?
Do not give up, even though you feel like it is very tough. It gets better, and you'll end up loving it in the end.
To stick with it. I quit probably like 6 times between when I started band and now. But it's really, really important to keep going. It's only going to get easier and more fun, and you're going to build some relationships that, you know, will last the rest of your life. I have friends from my first year here that I'll never forget.
Stick with it. I've wanted to quit so much. I've pretty much quit sometimes, but I don't think you can experience something as good as this community, and I think that this band really has something that everyone should experience.
Stick with it. There's going to be times where you absolutely hate it. That's okay. It happens. Just stick with it. You're gonna love it.
Yes, it's band, but if you take it too seriously, it's not as fun.
Unfortunately, every year, there are bound to be some tragedy. In order to recognize and pay our respects to those we have lost this season, we have created this in memoriam.
The E key.
The hi-hat.
Maddie's car.
The 2 tenor Spocks that broke within a week of each other and never got fixed.
The staff members that showed up in the beginning and then never again.
Curtis.
Molly.
Dave.
Maddie, though it wasn't her fault.
Sydney, though it wasn't her fault.
Mr. Mike. And thus concludes our In Memoriam.
We have been your hosts, Lauren
and Danae,
and we hope you enjoy the rest of this banquet.
Baseline section later. Anya Levine, signing off.
This is Color Guard Captain Sky Sweeney, signing off.
This is Ryan Leone, signing off.
This is Section Leader Danae Newhouse, signing off.
Section Leader Lauren Oganowski, signing off.
Ow. Yeah. That'll hurt watching this back, man.